house cat broke up and I'm the day after Friday the 13th, it was Saturday the 14th of September 1991. It's been a crazy week because that Monday I'd seen Nirvana play in Memphis at the New Daisy Theater. About a 900 seater, and there were about 128 people there. And then the next day, MTV started playing Smells Like Teen Spirit. And within like 2 weeks, they could have sold out any arena in town. But Adam's House Cat was at the end of its road. We've been together about 6 years, 6 years and a month. And on Friday the 13th, I woke up in Memphis, Tennessee, and my car was stolen. And on Saturday the 14th, Adam's House Cat played our last ever show.
And we sucked. Actually, it was a pretty good show.
It's a pretty good show. It's okay.
It's a good show.
No, I'm good. No, okay. No.
Anyway, he and I didn't get the memo that when your band breaks up, you're supposed to quit playing together. And here we are. It's been 30 years. Fuck us. Was a pretty good band, and we were a little misguided, to put it mildly. We had some really bad hair because it was the 80s, you know.
Yeah, that's changed.
We had this like weakness for train songs, and I think we had like 8 of them, and we even like made this like 4-track album called Trains of Thought, which we thought was really, really artsy and original. And this song is on it. I wrote this song in 1987 about my parents' divorce. And it became a hit in 1992, but it was a different song in some other band that made millions and millions of dollars. And at that time, I was like almost homeless. He and I were living in this like shithole, terrible ghetto apartment in Auburn, Alabama. And I turn on the TV.
Yeah, the closest we ever came to homeless was when we were roommates. Either of us.
Actually, I was homeless in 2001.
That's a different story. Yeah. Well, yeah.
Except for Jen taking me in and letting me sleep on the couch. And her storage room. You remember the storage room?
I know, right?
But I digress, as I tend to do, at Heathen's Homecoming. Because I know we're all friends here, so we can tell dirty stories and talk bad about people, good about people. Anyway, this was Adam's House Cat's hit single that we didn't have a hit with. And so this song's called Runaway Train. Sure.